Hello, massage nerds. Today we're going to be doing the dermatologic pathologies. There's 18 of them, so I'm going to break it up into three parts. Today will be part one, part two, and part three. And this is the last of the pathologies, and I'm so grateful for that. We'll be done with pathology after that. So let's start with acne. An acne is inflammation and or infection of the sebaceous hair follicles or the hair glands. It is associated with the sebaceous glands where they are more predominant, which is usually the face, the V-neck of the neck, the chest, the upper back, the shoulders. So it can happen just in anywhere of those places. It is more common in teenagers, and that's due to overproduction of sebaceous glands and hormones also. And even though it's not life-threatening, it is very distressing. So when you give a massage to someone that has acne, you need to avoid these areas because it might spread it more, and you might want to give them a somewhat of a relaxing massage to help them de-stress a little bit. And also, do not put heat on the table or on the areas where they have acne, because this will just aggravate it more. So you want to stay away from some of these areas, because a lot of times I know that I've had clients with acne and they can be so painful if you touch them. So go lightly and be careful with the lotions and oils that you might use, because they might break them out more. So make sure you talk to your client before you start with somebody that has acne. The next one is athlete's foot, and this is a fungal infection, usually on the plantar side and in between the toes and the sole of the foot. It's prevalent in teenagers and males, and that's usually because a lot of times they get it from the showers, if they play sports. So it's very important, that if you have teenagers, that you make them wear those flip-flops, when they go to the gym or, things like that. It's also common with people that have lower immune systems, like, diabetes. So it's easily infected and transmitted. So you've got to be careful to either wear gloves or work over the sheet if you're working on their feet. And also, when you wash your sheets with any contaminated sheets, actually, with whether there be cold sores or the athlete's foot or boils, anytime you're going to wash the sheets, make sure that you use something to disinfect them, like Clorox. If you add whatever your washer asks for, and hot water and detergent and the Clorox will disinfect the sheets. So for athlete's foot, you want to avoid the area and or use gloves or over the sheet. The next one is boils, and this one's similar to the acne, because what it is deeply infected hair follicles. They're a little deeper and they infect surrounding areas. They might need to take an antibiotic for this one. The cause is usually a staph infection or the MARS, the MARSA, and also or viral or bacterial. And it can be anywhere in the body. Like the acne is usually prevalent to certain areas, while a boil can be anywhere in the body. It is also caused by a lower immune system, people with diabetes. So avoid these areas that that might be contagious. So you don't want to work directly on any boils. You might want to refer them to a doctor too, to make sure that it is a boil, because a lot of times they can be mistaken with a lymph node, because they do feel like lymph nodes. So make sure that you avoid these areas and that you take every precaution afterwards, to wash the sheets if they are contaminated. Next will be bruises, and bruises are marks. I'm sure we all know what bruises are. Marks are, from the blood leaking from blood vessels, and it's in between the interstitial fluid. A bruise usually comes out like 24 hours after you hit yourself. We've all done that. We're walking through, a desk or something and hit our leg or our hip or our arms or, And it's also common with people that take Coumadin or blood thinners, any kind of a blood thinner. I see this a little bit more common with the elderly because the elderly usually, take a blood thinner, so they bruise easier. You don't want to work directly on the bruises, and you don't want to work too deeply on somebody that has, that's taking a blood thinner. So bruises usually disappear between, 4 to 7 days, and you can work on a bruise once it starts turning yellowish, greenish, when it's already fading. You can work lightly over it, but you never want to work directly on a bruise, which is slightly different than a hematoma. A hematoma is where the blood has pooled there for a long time, and they're usually bigger, and they feel very bumpy. You feel a bump underneath a hematoma, so definitely do not want to work on those either. So just find out what the bruising is for, and if anybody's on blood thinners, make sure you work lighter, and avoid the area, for 4 to 7 days if they've had bruising. The next one is burns. So there's different degrees of burns. They're caused damage to the epidermis, the dermis, the hypodermis, and even to the bone, depending on the severity. So a first degree burn is just the epidermis, which is your topical skin. The second degree burn may affect the epidermis and parts of the dermis, but it still doesn't damage the sebaceous glands or the sweat glands or the Merkel disc or anything like that. They're a little bit deeper. But a third degree burn will burn, through to the layer of the epidermis, the dermis, and the hypodermis, and then the fourth degree burns are the ones that are really deep, that can burn, all the way to the bone and the muscle. Those are, people are in the hospital, extremely dangerous. I'm sure you're not going to see any of those clients. And you can get sunburns, like a first degree sunburn. An example is like sunburn. That's a perfect example of a first degree sunburn. When you lay out in the sun for too long and your skin starts peeling, well, that's the epidermis, and that's a first degree burn. However, you can get burns from radiation, from chemicals, like some of these drain openers, they're very potent, so you can get, burns from chemicals. From heat exposure, from cold exposure, from friction, rug burns. That's like a rug burn. That's what that is, friction. So be careful. Make sure that your client is completely healed after a burn before you touch it. We've all seen burns, probably even from our iron curlers. I know I burnt my forehead one time, and or the stove. So be careful, avoid it. And until they are completely healed. So the next will be cold sores and fever blisters. And this is a recurrent viral infection that affects the mucous membranes and on the skin, on the mucous membranes. It's also known as fever blisters and oral herpes simplex. So, it is contagious, so you definitely want to avoid, these areas. It can be spread by utensils, or infected skin if you touch or kiss somebody that has, the herpes simplex, or oral to genital, contact. So this is highly contagious. You want to avoid anybody that has a cold sore around that area, and take precautionary, measures if you're working on somebody, either by wearing gloves and, make sure that you sanitize your sheets, just with Clorox and hot water, and follow your washer's instructions. It can also flare up, because of stress. So you want to give your client a nice relaxing massage if it's a flare up, because they do get flare ups, occasionally. Occasionally, it usually doesn't, go away. It just lays dormant, and something will bring it up. So be careful, with some clients that, this is good medical history that you take on your intake. You'll find out if you see any cold sores that they might forget to tell you. You may want to address that, before the session, and just avoid the area. Just avoid the area and you'll be fine. And make sure that that you wash your sheets in hot water, for people that have cold sores or boils, or athlete's foot because these are highly contagious. And so this is the first six, and part two we'll start with decubitus ulcers, which is when somebody has been laying on, you know, on the, usually with the elderly, it's very common because they lay in one position. But I'll tackle part two the next time. Until the next time, create a great day.